Hey guys, it's the ASMR Problems, and today we're going to be playing a game called Loop Hero. I kind of had to set it up beforehand, because anytime you open it, the sound is all the way out. So I believe it should be at the correct setting, so we're just going to kind of jump into it. This is a roguelite deck builder. Kind of game. You'll see when we get into it. I think I've seen IGP play it, but I've only watched one person play it, and I think it was him. I could be mistaken. Missed the first one, but no one notices it. No one can stop it. I'm racing to the last place where there is still hope. I need to make it before it is too late. The sounds of agony will quickly fade. The world will be destroyed. Even the memory of it will be gone. And even if there is absolutely no chance of bringing it all back, there will always be someone who's willing to do the impossible. In a place without space, without time, without memories. Where am I? I can't see anything except this path. My head is killing me. I remember only a skeleton with a staff. Up in the sky, this is darkness was coming from him. Did he destroy everything around here? Just standing here won't do me any good, I guess. Alright. Planning to change between adventure, traveling through the map, and planning stop modes. Press the switch, right click, or space. Continue your journey by changing the game mode. So there's our guy walking around this circle map. Hope I'll be able to find some shelter before nightfall, if night still even exists without the sky, that is. So this is our guy. He walks around in a circle, and he fights things, and you place little markers and different things on the path and off the path, and I guess we'll just get to it as we get to it. Pay attention to the day progress bar at the top of the screen. New enemies usually appear at the end of the day. Continue your journey. A living ball of slime. Quite a nuisance. They digest anything they can. Hey, I remember this creature. Maybe I just need to freshen up my memory and everything will go back to normal. Traveling, fighting, and most other actions are done automatically. Player can affect them directly. So we won. It's hard to fight with your bare hands. I think there's an undigested weapon in the remains of that thing. You have an inventory, an item slot. So we got an axe. 3 to 5. I think we don't have anything equipped right now. There we go. I think I remember there was a grove nearby. Are these even my memories? Or do they belong to that slime? So here is kind of the deck builder roguelite part. You have different cards that show up here, and you can place them on the map. So the grove, a gentle rustle of leaves, a crack on a dry branch, and a feeling of being watched, spawns a rat wolf every 2 days. Rat wolves can move to adjacent tiles. So spawns enemies for us to destroy. And here's our day at the top. So it spawned one wolf. A forest rat wolf. I was right. Some emotional stress, a few vivid images, and a bit of adrenaline, and I'll forget it all. Like a bad dream. I thought he was trying to remember. I mean, I'll remember it all. Like a bad. Damn it. Good thing nobody heard that. Okay, so this gives damage to it, so it's like an AoE weapon. As you probably already noticed, you can get new items and cards during battle. Some items have unique features, as do most of the cards. By hovering over an item or card, you can inspect its properties. Equip a new weapon and place your new cards on the map to continue. A thick forest. Nobody knows who or what could be lurking inside. Makes you a bit nervous. +1 to the hero's attack speed. I'm like the type of person that loves attack speed. Rock. Its magnificent appearance gives you strength. +2 HP. +2 HP more for every adjacent rock or mountain. So these you can place on the map anywhere. I know there's a certain order you need to do things. Forest also can go anywhere. Let's put the forest on like the edge of the mountains. Good. So there's a mountain over there and a forest over here. The world's almost back. The branches and stones in my backpack are a sure sign of that. Some of your actions will yield resources that you will need later on, but not right now. But that shouldn't stop you from looking at them right now. I think it's time I get some rest. The game itself is a journey on a looped path. Only you will decide when it's time for the hero to return to camp. Either you or the fangs and claws of your enemies, of course. You can retreat almost any time, but a special animation will let you know when it's safer to do so. Retreat to the camp by pressing the button. Alright, I guess we gotta go now. So, when he's running down here, I think, you will keep one wood and one stone. You consider returning to the cozy camp right now, while you're still alive and walking. Good thing the camp is right nearby. Now's the perfect chance. You will keep all resources. And I guess that they're going to force you. It's cold and dark here. A small fire can solve both of these problems. Alright, so we have a little camp builder feature, which needs exactly what we have. Part of the tutorial, building a campfire. And there we go, there's our campfire. Congratulations! You've beaten this annoying tutorial. You can now start your first expedition, or not. Do as you wish. A common campfire, warm and cozy. Monsters keep away from it, so it's a nice spot to have some rest between your travels. It's also the center of your camp and the starting point of your adventures. The hero restores 20% his max HP upon entering the campfire title. Alright, let's go on an expedition then. Looks like the skeleton guy we fought earlier. This path, everything is wrong, but I remember. It looks like a completely different place, and it's empty again. Do my actions have any meaning? Like I have a choice. If I need to give up and cry to save the world, I am the worst savior of all. Let's do it. He walks pretty slow too. I changed his color earlier, but the settings revert every time I play, so I'm hoping it'll at least save my progress. I'm not sure yet. Alright, let's put this on. Gives us 92 max HP. Alright, let's see. Can we pause it? Yeah, we can pause it. So we got a vampire mansion. Hungry eyes follow your every move through the holes in the roof, as vampires to battle on the tiles around it. We don't have to play these either. They stack up, but then I think it like fills up at a certain point. Then you have the meadow, which heals 2 HP at the start of each day. So I think we get healed here. And there's a big group here. So I think we should play... Oh, the meadow. Never mind. I thought the meadow was part of it. Well, let's stick it over here then. In the mansion. Let's put it here. That'll let us heal. It's kind of dangerous to put it at the end, because then we'll be like low health. Whereas here we'll be... We'll put it here. There are cards to destroy it, but I don't think... I'm not sure if we'll have it. Yeah. Okay, we got another meadow. We're just gonna keep combining them. Spider Cocoon. A silky bastion of eight-legged hunters. Spawns a spider on an adjacent tile once a day. Okay, so... if we put it in, so like here, it can only do adjacent. So I think that's maybe just these two. I'm not sure. We'll find out. Plus, I don't want to make it too difficult right off the start. I didn't see we got this too. Oh, we got quite a bit of stuff. Got a mountain for one. Put that down here. It's like a rock, but really big. Plus 5 HP for each adjacent rock or mountain. And then we got a ring of attack speed, of course. Yes. We'll probably switch it out. That one, the other one looks more rare, but we'll find out. Got a sword. We can actually do damage, 3 to 5 now. And then a ring. Damage to all. Counter and evasion. Ring and ring. They're both just basic, I guess. This one, though, deals 2 more damage. Okay, so after we use it, whatever was there before is gone. First blood. Got an achievement. Okay, let's see. Oblivion. A bit of the Lich's magic. Causes anything to be totally forgotten. Erases any established tiles. Erases monsters from the road. I think this is the single tile destruction where we can destroy like one thing. Cemetery. A place for the dead. And for some of the living, occasionally. Spawns a skeleton every 3 days. I think... put it here. So hopefully not too many will have spawned already. We'll take this rock and we'll put it here. So I think we get another 5 HP. Let's keep going. I think there's our health here. Alright, so let's just keep working on our stuff here. Maybe it looks like we've lost more health because I'm increasing his max HP. Let's see. I don't know if we can... is this two-handed? No. We're fine. So we got a... higher damage spear with counter aim regen per second, which is actually pretty good, I think. Let's see, I haven't been paying attention. Yeah, so it goes up pretty quick. I think there's something to do with if you have this full, these will turn into resources, maybe? I forget. Grove. Okay, so this is the rat wolf. I'll put that over here. So now we heal up. Full health. I don't know if there's any vampires yet. I guess not. What do we got here? Alright. I thought it was a big one, but it's just a normal one. Okay, so we got a treasury. The thick walls guard all kinds of riches from thieves and previous owners. Gives a random basic resource after placing anything on an empty tile around it. Must be surrounded by empty space when you build it. Alright, so these are the only ones with empty space. So we'll put it up here. I think you build around it, and then it gives you like a gargoyle or something like that. We're gonna keep up with our, let's see. Let's put it here. I wanna build, I might have already messed it up. I think you need like three of these, and then these surround it. I'm not sure. So this might be tough. This is three spiders. But then we also have the damage to all. Okay, not too bad. We got another oblivion. We don't really need it. And we don't need these shields either. I guess if it came down to it, we could use these just to kill, like, a group if we needed a little bit of time to heal. So we got two mountains. I think if we do this, I'm not sure. We'll find out. I probably messed it up, but that's alright. Okay, let's see. We got it. This is down. This is down. I guess it's, like random. I thought it might have been, the more you progress, the higher up it went. Alright, let's see. 92, 91, yeah. Got another spider cocoon. I think we'll put it down here. Got a rat wolf ahead. I'm not sure what this is. Map completion. When this bar is filled, the boss of the chapter will appear on the campfire tile. I see. Put another grove here. Ooh, 12 to 18 damage. We don't get the counter or the regen though. But it's a lot of damage. We'd probably save the health by not having to fight as much. Back off, human. A vampire. A vampire. Where are your lands? If your farmers need help, I would be glad to offer it. No more lands. No more flock. Only hundreds of years of emptiness. And hundreds of years of hunger. Slowly changing. Or quickly changing, I guess. Save yourself while you still can. I don't know how long I can keep my head on straight. What hundreds of years are you talking about? Your mind is easy to trick, but you can't trick my hunger. It demands its fill. Every sip, every drop of blood will go to satiate it. I'm too weak, but you can help me, and it will get this crumbled world right. That's right. I'm doing this not just for myself, but for everyone, in the name of the greater good. So be grateful for my hard work, and just let me bleed you dry. No thank you. Okay. So he's not too tough. He does heal. Vampires often owned our lands. They kept the peace and helped our settlements prosper. But this won't do at all. Now they are just pale shadows of their former selves, both physically and mentally. Apparently, blood of other creatures can't sustain them. He wasn't joking about the hunger. Even the creatures around him were imbued with the power to drain someone else's life. Alright, so what did we get? We got a 711 with attack speed and regen. 711. This one's a lot better. Evasion and vampirism. That's really good. So we don't really have to worry about the regen now. Or we could use it and then kind of double up on it. Evasion, vampirism, regen. We lose damage to all. And the counter. We're going to use it anyways. this rock down here. Alright, we have 3 spiders. I don't think they should be a problem. It would be nice if we could just one hit these guys, but... Alright, we got some new stuff. The meadow is still the same. The mountain, we'll put here. Battlefield. It smells of blood and steel. Spawns a chest on an adjacent tile, each loop. Enemies on the tiles around it become ghosts when they die. I guess let's put it here. Here. I'm not sure. I think that means it should spawn a chest here every turn. And I don't think it's close enough. He might turn it into a ghost. I'm not sure how it works. See, we gain health each time. So hopefully it's not too difficult. Road Lantern. A small spot of light in this grim world. Reduces the maximum number of spawning enemies on the tile around it. Road Lantern effects can stack. So I think we should put it here. Or should we put it here? No, I think here. That'll stop it from spawning too many vampires. Well, spiders. I got another one, and it did say they stack. So let's put it there. Lots of evades, that's good. They're attacking quick. Okay, got another cemetery. 5% chance of spawning a slime once a day. Oh, that's the regular one. Okay. Okay, so we did get a resource. I think we have to build it around that. Like all the way around. And there's a chest though. Got a skeleton coming up. Looks like we get a resource from this as well. Ten and counter. That's a lot of counter. 19%? Definitely. I don't know if that's like an automatic like damage counter. Or if that's saying you have percentage to, like, counter them. It's a lot more health, but we lose the vampires. I might kind of want to keep it. See, we have Beacon. A worthless landmark in a world with no direction. Plus 40% movement speed within its range. Plus 20 attack speed for all units. That's you and everything else. Let's see, let's put it. I don't want to put it here. That's kind of getting built up. I may have to destroy some of it. But let's put it here for all the slimes. Put this there. Treasury here. That way, so if we build something here, we'll get double. Oh, I'm not gonna hold off on the spider. Well, no, we'll put it here. Then we get our chest. Nice. Okay, so we got some health from it too. 10 to 16. 10 to 16. With vampirism. Better defense, pure damage, and damage to all. But we lose the counter. I don't know how good that is. And I kind of want to use this. We'll just put that on. I'm not sure about this. Pure damage. And damage to all. I don't know. Here, and then I'm gonna put one there. I don't know if it gives us a boost or anything, but this one's gonna be the challenge. As well as we have, yeah, we might die here. Cause they're evading and. That's a lot of HP. I like the vampirism one, but I'm gonna leave the counter. Somewhere. Right there. Got another vampire mansion. And then we can put this metal here. Okay, so it didn't do anything. I thought it was going to. I want to try and keep these separate so they don't build up like that one was. So we have a goblin camp. I don't know where it came from. The sound of backstabbing can be heard from miles away. It spawns a goblin on adjacent tile once a day. Appears for every 10 mountain rock tiles. Okay, that's where it came from. I think they're pretty difficult. And they're starting to stack up. What those are. And things are getting more difficult for him. And to be honest, we're not even halfway towards the boss yet. We'll go ahead and take this. It's double the defense. And gives us regen instead. Yeah, we're probably gonna die here. We lose the regen and vampirism, so we're gonna keep what we have. I think we can make up a little health here. so we did make a mountain peak. A stone giant could support the sky itself if it weren't already gone. Plus 120 max HP, plus 5 max HP for every adjacent mountain rock tile. Spawns a harpy every 2 days. I don't know where the harpy spawns either. But I don't think we're going to stay that long anyways. I kind of want to retreat in a little bit. I think we'll stop before these spiders come on, because 4 spiders I think will kill us. Unless we get something crazy. I forgot though, I can do this. Big difference in, but that's 4 things, so we're gonna retreat for now. We're gonna lose, let's see, branches, pebbles, a rock, ration, and a noticeable change. This is enough to turn a caterpillar into a butterfly, a seed into a sprout, a drop of water into a stream. It will turn itself into something else too if you collect enough of it. 20 changes forms a complete metamorphosis. So we'd have to get 20, and that's only 5. Get 8 of them. Yeah, we're gonna retreat. We have quite a few different things. I can't believe it. Hey everybody, the boy managed to return. Survivors? Does this mean I'm not alone anymore? Where did you come from? Is there still a place without darkness? We don't know where we came from, that or can't remember. These few people are all that's left of our group. I think. You're not sure? We're not sure. Reached that conclusion based on the abandoned luggage and leftover daily rations. Each day we see the signs of other people's presence around us, but as far as we know, they didn't exist and never did. It's like we forgot them. Forgot them? Exactly. It's as if people are disappearing every day, and we instantly forget they existed. Just like we forgot where we came from, and our families. Maybe even ourselves. My name is Jota. That I still remember. Everyone else's memories are not much better. That's why I remember so little about myself. Everything is forgotten. But wait, you said I managed to return? That means you remember I was here? Yes, that's why it's important to us. We saw you leave, but you were gone before we could approach you. Listen, we can't keep wandering in this emptiness anymore. There's a campfire here, and enough space for a few sleeping bags. A real luxury in these dark times. What do you say? Of course you can stay. I'd be grateful if we could team up. I want to put everything right. I'm only beginning to remember the world as it was before. But there's no point without other people. It's too lonely without them. Remember the world? I don't get what you're talking about. I'm too exhausted. But we'll be glad if you can help us, and we'll be glad to help you. Just don't ask us to follow you out there. I don't know how you managed to return, but for us leaving the group is too dangerous. I will ask no such thing of you. For now I just want to have a place to return to, a place where I can hear other people's voices. We weren't joking about helping you. Here are a few items that the survivors that survived the cataclysm. And don't vanish. Don't become forgotten. Take it. You might need it. Okay, we got a few more things. Let's see. Here's our campfire. Original. We have survivor tents. Can't be destroyed, its inhabitants will gladly move to better housing if you build it. Okay, so these are all the same. What can we build? Okay, so we can build a field kitchen. What are we missing? We're missing something. You can see it, like, right here. It's like you're missing a spot. I'm missing a spot here too. That doesn't make sense. Maybe it's saying it'll take one spot. I'm not sure. Got another achievement though. Foundation stone. Do you know the difference between a good cook and a bad cook? The flood made by a good cook is tastier. Food. I read flood. What? You're waiting for something more elaborate? Sometimes the truth is very simple. Look, I have a cauldron, a hearth, a couple of knives, a bucket of potatoes, three onions, and some ham. Nothing special. Everything is very simple. But give me a few minutes and everyone in this camp will be running to my table, following the tasty smell of a good stew. Alright, a very important place for any camp. If your nose isn't lying, there's good food here. Plus 10% to the campfire's healing power, so now it's at 30. Unlocks the Blood Grove card. Can we build anything else? We unlock some more things, but we don't have enough materials. So I like this because it's like a skill tree almost, but for buildings and cards. Alright, let's see. Upgrade building. Now we need more stuff. We can dismantle it, but I don't want to. Okay, so we've unlocked some things. Our deck. Okay. So it has to be greater than 7 and less than 4, I'm guessing. Blood Grove. A living forest. It preys on wounded occupants of the tile around it. May spawn something dreadful from their remains. Can be placed adjacent to the road, near other trees. Its roots devour enemies that have less than 15% health left. So I guess saying that either way, me or the enemy, if you have 15% health, you die. Okay. Let's go ahead and do one more. This will probably be the last one. Wanted to make a little bit longer video, but it also is very hot in here with the AC off. I'm down in Texas, so it's not the worst. I've been in worse conditions, but alright, we got a treasury first off. Let's put that here. Let's go ahead and equip our armor and our weapon. Pretty good armor for starting off. 97 health. Alright, let's put a grove right here and a meadow right here. Alright. Horse. And none. So that's better. Let's see. I'll just put them up here. So we get more things on the direct adjacents. our treasury, which we can put right here. Defense goes down, but pure attack goes up. I want to see our pure damage. I want to see what that does. Get our health back. Get a pure damage ring. So now we're doing 8-9 pure damage. I don't know if maybe that helps us out with the skeletons who are a little bit beefier. First round is always probably going to be pretty easy. Let's put it here. We got quite a bit off that one. Not as good, and a little bit better. Instead of 3-5, it's 4-6, so. We got our first blood grove. Can be placed on the road near other trees. I see. There we go. Well, I don't get the benefit. I guess they die quicker for us as well. That makes sense. 7 to 11. Better, but we lose the attack speed and vampirism. Cemetery here. Worried about the spiders. I should have put this up one, then we could have got a tower. Alright, let's see. 7-11. 10% evasion. I think I want the evasion. I think that helps out more than we think. You see, when things get passed on, it gives us resources. What is this slime? Is that a different colored one? Is that the same one? It's the same. I thought it was gold for some reason. Grove. Oh, I thought it wouldn't. I thought it was trying to let us, and then it wouldn't. Okay. I don't know. We have a limiter here, so hopefully it won't get too bad. I think there's some kind of bonus or something by putting them together. What is that? Living has a soul? Wonder what that means. Devours monsters that have less than. The hero and his allies will become entangled instead. Cannot devour blood golems or swarm creatures. Strange. I like this. It's, let's see, we'll put that here. I should have moved it up one. Yeah, you can't move them. It's not looking good. There we go. Need to get them taken care of. So I wonder what happens. I guess you can put, you can put mountains over here too. And that's not good. It's gonna be close. I hope he evades me. I hope I evade. Let's pause. Attack speed. We'll take it. Vampirism. Enemies on tiles around it can become ghosts when they die. What happens if we put two battlefields? What is this? Blood path. Spawns a blood clot every 4 days. Well, good thing we're here now, not 4 days later. Seems like we're dealing less damage. I don't know if they're ghosts. Let's see, what do we get? We get the preserved rock, so we're gonna take it. I think we're gonna die pretty soon, so that's why I wanted to leave. Another success. You've returned, and we still remember you. Unbelievable. Yeah. It's good to be back, but I'd hardly call it a success. My old memories of the world were gone. The path was empty again, and there was only darkness everywhere I looked. Interesting. So technically, you remembered you forgot something. We could find a way to use that. Let's talk about something more positive. We managed to tidy up this place. Time for the next step. What do you have in mind? Expanding the camp. We have people with all sorts of skills, from the cook to the alchemist, but each needs a place to work. However, we can't build anything with the local materials. You find a branch or a rock, turn away for a second, and it's gone. I'm afraid only you can solve this problem. The materials that survive your trips always look suitable for building. Those are just pebbles and splinters. How can you build anything with them? Curious, huh? I realized when I saw your campfire, the things you find seem to spread stability to similar materials and things. It's only a little change, but it's still something. Even a small branch is enough to make a wooden fence exist without constant oversight. Alright, what can we build now? be able to build something. Thirteen makes metal. That's what is this? Stable metal. So yeah, we have one. Preserve rock, I bet that's, yeah, preserve pebbles. Okay, so these are like getting 10 pieces, and this is like getting 13. Food supply, so we need 12 of these. Okay, so this probably makes something. I bet it's this, whatever this thing is. Okay. Kind of reminds me of Fallout. Alright guys, well, I'm going to stop here for tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like the video, comment if you want to see more of it. I know there is a lot more to this. There's several expeditions. As you can see, this is just one. We haven't even seen the boss yet. It does take time. I might play offline. Later, tomorrow, weekend, you know, whatnot. Try and build this up a little bit. But if you guys want to watch me go through it, you know, just comment down below. And I hope you guys have a great night. Talk to you later. Bye.